cuando empezamos Tulianos, esto nos parecía una sorpresa. Ian Anderson.
Duck. It works. Brilliant. Thank you.
No. How is it, Florian? You looking good? Is that for you or forever? Not for me, anyway. Okay, let's do it.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the show. Nice to see you. Thanks for having us here. Hola! Hola! Here's a little blues tune from 1968. So, welcome to Florian O'Parle on stage here, playing guitar, Florian O'Parle. Hey! And then joining us here on stage right, keyboard player from Jethro Tull. His name is John O'Hara.
I nearly called you Ron O'Hara. I don't know why.
This is my Waking Up in the Morning song from 1970. Something like that. It's called Life is a Long Song. When you're falling awake and you take stock of the new day, and you hear your voice croak as you choke on what you need to say. Well, don't you fret, don't you fear, I will bring you good cheer. Life's a long song, life's a long song, life's a long song, yeah. If you wait in your plane, I will fail. As the verses unfold and your soul suffers the long day, and the 12 o'clock moon spins the room, you struggle on your way. Well, don't you sigh, don't you cry, lift the dust from your eye. Life's a long song, life's a long song, life's a long song, yeah. We will meet in the sweet light of dawn, as the Baker Street train spills your pain all over your new dress, and the symphony sounds underground with you under duress. Well, don't you squeal as a heel grinds you under the wheels. Life's a long song, life's a long song, life's a long song, yeah. But the tune ends to sing her song. Now, a tune from the Aqualung album. It's not very often played, for reasons that'll become immediately obvious. This one, I've almost forgotten what this is about. The lyrics are very strange, very surreal. It's a piece of music called Up to Me, filled with jolly chuckles.
One, two, three, four. You tell me that we've gone too far. Come riding up to me. Make the scene at Cousin Jack's. Leave him to put the bottles back. Man says glasses that I cracked. It was up to me. Sung far too wide, it was up to me. Tires down on your bicycle, you know it feels like an icicle. The yellow-fingered smoky girl is looking up to me. Yeah.
Well, I'm a common working man with a half a bitter bread and jam. And if it pleases me, I'll put one on your man. When the copper fades away, thanks very much. A piece from the Aqualung album there. Now, a bit of music probably in the realms of folk rock. Sort of. This is a piece from the Songs from the Wood album about a little fella who keeps alive all things that grow during the cold and dark. Hello, hello. Yeah, hi, hi. Yeah, okay. The cold and dark winter months. His name is Jack in the Green. Have you seen Jack in the Green with his long tail hanging down? He quietly sits under every tree in the folds of his velvet gown. He drinks from the empty acorn cup that you, the town's feet, bestows, and taps his cane upon the ground, signals the storms it's time to grow. Yeah. It's no fun being Jack in the Green. No place to dance, no time for song. He wears the colors of the summer's holding and carries the green flag all winter long. Jack, do you never sleep? Does the green still run deep in your heart? Or will these changing times, motorways, power lines keep us apart? Well, I don't think so. I saw some grass growing through the papers today. And the rowan, the oak, and the holly tree are hard the charges left for him to groom. Each blade of grass whispers Jack in the Green. Oh, Jack, please help me through a winter's night.
And we are the berries on the holly tree. And the mistle thrush is coming, jangled out the light.
Thanks very much, Jack in the Green. Now, a piece of music which is really quite a new song, one that is about a little rabbity guy, little hare, that crawled in under the fence of our garden while I was away and came to live with us. And he met my terrier dog, and the dog ate the little rabbity guy. So that was the end of him, except for this song, which is called Hare in the Wine Cup. Features John O'Hara on the accordion and the bongo thingy. No, we don't do that now. We don't. No, okay. Well, forget that. Forget that. Hare in the Wine Cup.
There's a hare in the wine cup moving just yesterday, taking for freedom sweet incarceration. Faintly bewildered and furry brown innocence, tunneled and slithered in under the fence. There's a hare in the wine cup, hare in the wine cup. Let's hope the mad patter they'll tarry us sleeping. Too fat and too lazy to go for the killing. This hare without spectacles doesn't do dinner. Candlelit pot's food for saint or for sinner. There's a hare in the wine cup. Hare in the wine cup. Hare in a wine cup, suitably fitting. Hare in a wine cup, silently sitting. Silently sitting. To tear away labyrinth, aspires to be part of the family or furniture. This hair without spectacles doesn't do dinner. Candlelit pot's good for saint or for sinner. And there's a hair in a wine cup. Suitably fitting, hare in a wine cup, silently sitting. Silently sitting. Silently sitting. Silently sitting. There's a hare in a wine cup.
Okay. One of the tunes that was on the Aqualung album was recorded in four different ways at the time of the original making of the record, and this is one of the alternate versions of a song originally called Wandering Aloud on the record, but rechristened and rearranged in a completely different first half. It's called Wandering Again, and you won't have heard this before.
There's a stillness hard path on a deathly unliving sea, and the motor car magical world long since ceased to be. When the eve-bitten apple returned to destroy the tree, incestuous ancestry, Sharapan right, calling you millions, throws the world on its side, supporting their far-flung illusions, the national curse. Those with no sandwiches, please get off the bottles. The excrement bubbles, the centuries slime and decays, and the brainwashing government lackeys, whatever's the same. It's under control, and you'll soon be on your way to a grand year for babies and crisp panel games. Of the hot, hungry millions, you'll be sure to remain. The national resources are dwindling, and no one grows old. And those with no homes to go to, please dig themselves holes. Wandered through quiet lands, felt the first breath of snow, searched for the last pigeon, slate gray, I've been told. She crushed in the rush, heard its song, and left it to die. At once felt remorse, and were touched by the loss of our own. Held its poor broken head in her hands, dropped some tears in the stone. And it's only the taking that makes you ba-da-da-da-da what you are. Wandering aloud, will a son one day be born to share in our infancy, path we've worn. In the aging seclusion of this earth that our birth did surprise, yeah, we'll open his eyes.
Nah, let's go to quill.
is the tune, which is from a forthcoming album that you'll have to wait at least for another 6 or 7 months to hear. It's a piece of music dedicated to an old friend from 1972. It's called Adrift and Dumbfounded. Crossroads, a new street, an old town. Gerald, something from New Home on Sea. Thinking back to the childhood he once was. All bread and butter and jam for his tea. Of madness, muttered apologies late for a meeting. Too much intensity, too much pain, sadness, crestfallen hand off glances too fleeting. He was your golden boy, his adrift and dumbfounded, with nowhere to go, no appointments to keep. Our little boy is adrift and dumbfounded, head on hot pillow waiting for sleep. Society, selfish, uncaring, cobble-brained adult of country soothing, desperate measures, desperately tearing, at last vestige of dignity pays for the losing. He was your golden boy, his adrift and dumbfounded, with nowhere to go, no appointments to keep. He's our little boy, is adrift and dumbfounded, head on hot pillow waiting for sleep. He's our little boy, is adrift and dumbfounded, head on hot pillow waiting for sleep. Thanks very much indeed. Thank you. Adrift and Dumbfounded. Let's get this right. Yeah. Okay. Where are we now? Yes, we are. Now we have a special guest this evening, and we'll welcome her as a singer-songwriter from your own fair city. She sent me one of her songs, and I liked it so much, I said, come and play, since you're just around the corner. Please welcome onto the stage to play the borrowed guitar. Please welcome Eva Bastero Bertoli. Hey!
Well done, you put that down without, yeah, showing too much. There you go, brilliant.
Okay, it's a piece of music that Eva wrote called Ladies in Black. I don't think I can persuade her to talk to you, but say hello.
I will try.
You'll try.
Hola a todos. Bueno.
Yeah.
No cal que us digui l'honor que és per mi tocar amb el John O'Hara, el Floriano Pale I Lillian Anderson. És una obvietat, o sigui que... la cançó que tocarem ara es diu Les Parques, però en anglès quedava molt lleig I llavors l'he titulat The Ladies in Black. No, it's okay.
Watch out for your back.
La, 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 la.
Eva Bastero Bertoli. Ladies in black, thank you.
Tambourine, there's one there. Look. You want me to pick it up? I should. Okay.
Yeah. There's a piece of music from the Thick as a Brick album, which we haven't played for many a long year. And it's one we're going to do a little section of somewhere in the middle. It's rather an odd thing to be playing acoustically, but we'll give it a good old go. This is a piece that's usually referred to as the Poet and the Painter. Quietly grazing at the grass down by the river, where swelling mountain waters move onward to the sea. The builder of the castles renews the age-old purpose and contemplates the milking girl whose offer is his need.
The woman of the household.
Afghan boy.
Now to do a quick retune. Oh, plectrum. There we go.
Just have to do a quick retune here as it gains in humidity and reduces in temperature, and guitars just, I guess, go to pieces. There you go.
Okay, not so bad, not so bad.
It's another one from the Aqualung album that... set on London's Hampstead Heath in the summer of 1970, about all kinds of weird people who populate public parks. Now, what am I thinking about here? This is called Mother Goose.
Oh, he plays with fire, that boy.
As I did walk by Hampstead Fair, came upon Mother Goose. So I turned her loose, she was screaming. And a foreign student said to me, was it really true? There are elephants and lions too at Piccadilly Circus. Walked down by the bathing pond to try and catch some sun. Saw at least 100 schoolgirls sobbing into handkerchiefs as one. I don't believe they knew I was a schoolboy. And a bearded lady said to me, if you start your raving and your misbehaving, you'll be sorry. And the chicken fancier came to play with his long red beard and his sister's weird. She drives a lorry. Down by the potting green, I pop them in their holes. 4 and 20 laborers were laboring and digging up their gold. I don't believe they knew that I was Long John Silver. saw Johnny Scarecrow make his rounds with his jet black hat, which he won't give back, stole it from a snowman. As I did walk by Hampstead Fair, came upon Mother Goose, so I turned her loose, she was screaming. Hi, Florian Opale here, who began as a classical guitarist when he was 5 years old. Also learned to play a little flamenco. Can't call it anything different. There's a piece he wrote when he was 8 years old. It's called Andantino. Please give a warm welcome to Florian Opale from München in Germany. Florian Opale. Thank you. Florian O'Pale on the acoustic guitar with Andantino. Okay, now a piece of music which John O'Hara loves because it's a piece of classical music and he's a classical musician originally. This is one of the two pieces, three pieces we're going to play by J.S. Bach. This one is a rather pretty piece which is called Bach's Prelude in C Major. John O'Hara on the piano. Thanks very much. Thank you. There you go, a little Bach beret there from the stand-up album. Now, Florian Opale is strapping on the plank of wood, the famous electric Gibson Les Paul guitar. Play a bit of thrash metal, a very disrespectful take on a beautiful piece of Bach music, one that you probably know from the cathedral organ thundering away at Bach's Toccata and Fugue. So here's Florian gonna do real serious damage to J.S. Bach as he turns in his grave uncomfortably at the very sound of Florian Opale's version of Bach's Toccata and Fugue. Florian Opale on the lead guitar there with Bach's Toccata and Fugue.
Oh, Budapest.
Shall I go for it?
What?
Shall I start?
No, because I have to check the tuning again,
okay.
Because it's... No, it's going to have to tune. Sorry.
This next one is from the Crest of a Knave album. It's a tune that was written following an evening concert in a town in Hungary that you may have heard of called Budapest. And this is the tale of a young athlete who caught the eye of our guitar player back then. This is simply called Budapest, and I'd like to thank you all for coming. It's really good to see you, and thanks for supporting the local bands and the local musicians who've joined us on stage tonight. They were great, and you'll have some more to come. So you're not just here to see us, it's those other folks too. Support your local musicians, whoever and wherever they are. Budapest. She was a middle distance runner. The translation wasn't clear. Could be a budding stately hero. International competition in a year. She was a good enough reason for a party. Well, you couldn't keep up on a hard track. While she ran a perfect circle and she wore a perfect smile in Budapest, off night in Budapest, we had the coffee up in the old gymnasium, dozen of the middle ends to check it on the key. Well, she was helming out at the backstage, stomping hearts and chewing beer. Yes, and the legs went on forever, like staring up at infinity through a wisp of cotton panty along a skin of satin sea. From the side pills, feel like you were playing for your life, if not the money. Hey, hey, hey. All night in Budapest, she bent down a lonely icebox, and she stopped some old warm white wine. T-shirt, pants, and skin. You know a ripple, just a hint of muscle. But the boys and me were heading west, so we left her to the late crew and a hot night in Budapest.
I saw her at the late night restaurant. She would send blue shivers down the wall. Yeah, but she didn't grace her table. In fact, she wasn't there at all. Yes, her legs went on forever, like staring up at him. A hot night in Budapest. Hot nights in Budapest. Hot nights in Budapest. Hot night in Budapest. Hot night in Budapest. Hot night in Budapest. It was a she didn't grace our table. In fact, she wasn't there at all. It was a hot night in Budapest. Thank you.
Thanks very much indeed. You've been very kind to us. Good to see you. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Goodbye, Florian O'Pale, John O'Hara. Good night. Wonder what would happen if you crossed. Living in the past with locomotive breath. This could be it. In the shuffling madness of the locomotive breath runs the all-time closer headlong to his death. While it feels a piston scraping, steam breaking on his brow. Oh, Charlie stole the handle and a train. Well, it won't stop going, no way to slow down. Oh, yeah. He sees his children jumping off stations one by one. His woman and his best friend in bed and having fun. When he's crawling down the corridor on his hands and knees,
shuffling madness of the locomotive breath. Runs the all-time loser and hung to his death. Well, he feels the piston scraping, steam breaking on his brow. Oh, Charlie, he stole the handle, and a train, it won't stop going, going to a slowdown. No way to slow down. The silence howling, well, he catches his angels as they fall. And the all-time winner has got him by the balls. Well, he picks up Kenny's rifle, it's open at page one. I think the card, he stole the handle, and a train, it won't stop going, no way to slow down. No way to slow down. Oh, no way to slow down. No way to slow down.
Thanks very much. Good night.